No, I felt good. I felt good. Made sure I ate the right thing before the game. I felt good.
So you had a stomach virus or what?
Yeah, I had just. Yes, stomach virus.
But no effects tonight. I mean, you felt.
Still before the game, I had to go to the bathroom once, but.
I mean, just another 30-point game. I mean, is this becoming? Do you feel that you could score 30 a night? I mean, average that. I mean, it seems like that's where it's heading right now.
I mean, you answered the question yourself. I'm just playing my game, as I said before. Trying to be aggressive and trying to make the right play to win games. I'm getting better as a player, and I can feel that. You know, I can read more things. The game slows down for me a little bit. And then you know, I'm learning how to draw more fouls, which is important to get to the line. And I'm growing as a player, and I think that's helping the team.
That sequence where you block the shot on one end and come down for the dunk on the other. How energizing is that for you and the team?
I love that play. I mean, obviously, but just the energy that was in the garden at that moment, it was unbelievable. I had to calm myself down to not free throw.
How did you guys work to not lose the momentum? How did you guys work to not lose that chemistry and momentum tonight?
No, we wanted to play, you know, for 48 minutes the same way, you know, playing hard defensively and doing the right thing offensively. But we still had the moments where we weren't doing what we're supposed to, making some maybe, you know, bad decisions offensively, early shots and things like that. And then defensively, they went to the same play, you know, 3, 4, 5 times in a row. We couldn't stop it. So there are still things we have to fix. But overall, I think the effort was there.
When they start to double you, how much does it help
that
you're still
putting
down, like, they're just not on the right
way? Yeah, I still have to get better at that, you know, just reading, make the right play, the right pass. But, I mean, every time I just turn around, there's, you know, very few guys that bother my shot, really. You know, when I just face up, I can shoot it, and I can make a play. But I'm going to have to be, you know, going forward, I'm going to have to be ready for those double teams coming and they're making the right pass.
Kristaps, ¿cuán importante ha sido tu preparación en la temporada muerta con Nowitzki para esta temporada? ¿Cómo eso te ha ayudado a lograr 6 partidos consecutivos de 30 puntos?
Bueno, con Dirk solo hemos pasado un par de días juntos. He intentado preguntar todas las cosas del mundo que quería saber y me ayudó. Bueno, me ayudó. En también prepararme para el Eurobasket. Me ayudó en también entrenamos juntos un par de entrenos y me enseñó algunos ejercicios que hace durante su carrera y la verdad que me ha gustado estar con él un par de días aprendiendo de él. Working out with Dirk this summer. I just had like, a couple of days together and as many questions as I could and just try to get as much information as I could from him and you know, a couple of workouts together.
Do you have a comment on what your brother
is
talking about?
I talked about that pregame. I'm done talking about that. Chris, when you talked
about that, and you kept saying, I just want to play ball and be on the court, how much comforting is that to you when you get to get out there and just put that behind you?
Yeah, thank you, too.
I mean, I'm pretty. I don't think about stuff too much. In through one ear and out through the other. And that's how in my whole life. Sometimes it works good for me and sometimes it doesn't. But that's how I am. I'm too loose and you know, I keep it simple for myself always. I focus on the things I need to focus on and everything else is just in and out and that's my mindset.
Tyson,
you
guys are learning how to play with
the lead from the Detroit game.
I think so. We're just realizing, you know, we always have a little issue going into the second half. We kind of always start a little, I don't know, they just teams come out with, you know, putting more pressure on us, and then, you know, we lose a couple of balls, and you know, the game can turn in that moment. And I think today we still could have done a better job, but we're more ready for it. We came out in the second half, and we're ready for them to put more pressure on us and
play
harder defense. And I think we've learned from the previous games that we gave.
Tyson Chandler said before that you could be the best player in the league someday. I mean, this is a guy who, the defensive player of the year, knows offensive talent. Do you feel like you're getting that respect from other veteran players? Can you notice that people are treating you like you are?
I don't really care about that much, you know. All I need is the respect from refs to get those calls. But I'm just playing basketball. As I said, I'm keeping it simple for myself, playing my game, doing the things I know how to do. And you know, it's nice to hear, you know, those kind of words from a veteran, from a defensive player of the year, as you said. It's nice to hear those things.
When you jump as high as that dunk on the last play, you're going to get the call. And now that one.
I jumped that high. I got to work on my balance. All right.
Thanks, Kevin. Thank you.